hook tool for quite a bit of it today. And we used the hook tool a little bit last time. And you can get one from Hostelut or a hook tool from Martel. And I believe Hostelix is milled and Martel's is casted. Martel's hook tool looks a little sturdier. Tonight we'll be using the one from Hostelut. And he's adding, I cannot spell that, but he is in Canada.
He's a Canadian. Michael's first name.
Michael Hostelut. I think it ends in an L-U-K.
You can get them from Bill, too.
Bill as well. Well, Bill does everything.
Yeah.
Not the hook, but the shaft.
Yeah. Where do you get the hook?
You can get it from Bill, you can get it from Michael Hostelut, or from Martel.
Craft Supply. We'll sell it to you.
Right.
All done, of course.
Yep. And so talking about the hook tool is you're honing it with a diamond. So you have a flat diamond here for the outside. Kind of like this portion here, just for the outside. And then the inside, you have another diamond, but it's round. And so that is what you kind of hone the inside with. And that's basically how you sharpen it.
It's high-speed steel?
I believe so.
Not carbon?
No, it's not carbon. And so that's what we're doing. This is a piece of maple, and hopefully by the end of this you'll be able to see through it, and nothing will go flying. If it does go flying, Tom, you're right in the middle. So it might hit you.
It won't hurt it. As long as it hits me in the head, I'm okay.
There you go. Once again, I'm using just a heavy metal rod. I have the arm brace, which I feel helps. And then when we get down into the bottom of it, this tool rest, it has holes in it. And this holes use any sort of thing to wedge it. Post pivot point. So you'll see once we get a little further, it helps out. It just gives you more leverage. So you could put them in the different holes. We'll use that a little bit later on.
Leverage for the shaft of the tool.
Yes.
So you're not sliding the rest.
Correct. And so you're not pulling so much with your hand. It's,
yeah.
How are you doing?
So we'll get started. So I'm gonna face off the piece and then we'll start boring it out. Which is a negative rake scraper by, who's it by again? Stuart Batty. Stuart Batty.
You call it clean mirror?
Right. And so the negative Rick scraper, it works, the burr is kind of what cuts it, and he says that it's sort of like using a 16 grit sandpaper with like a 320 finish. And it just kind of smoothens everything out for you. So that's what we're gonna use.
If you don't have that kind of finance, you can use a cabinet scraper. Just sharpen it up and bend it a little bit.
Have you ever tried it?
You'll be down to about 120 grit.
I tried it, it didn't work.
Well, that's because you are who you are.
Thanks for your insight.
You want me to give you some lessons?
Yeah.
No problem.
Relatively smooth. From here we'll face off and drill our hole. Now we're gonna drill out our hole. I think this is roughly a 2-inch drill bit. So you do it a couple times. You want to pull the bit out to cool it down, as well as so that you don't get the shavings to choke up your bit. And so we're just past halfway right now. I'll kind of eat out some of the insides here so that we can go back in and drill a little bit more. And because I do want to go back in and drill, I'm not going to mess with the bottom of this hole. Because if you take away the bottom of the hole or that nub in the middle, it's hard for this drill bit to find its way back.
Huh?
Say what?
Say that again.
Come again?
You shot what?
You just
the bottom
Yes. And I have the 6mm from Simon Hope, simply because I found that as you're using the hook tool to remove some of the wood, if for some reason it gets out of round on that inside, it's hard to fix it with the hook tool. So then I have the 6mm there just in case.
How do you get out of round? Is it wobbles or something?
It's not a wobble. It's almost like this hook tool will kind of gouge it out. It's also not really a catch. It's just the hook tool gouges out a little bit. And
may not be uniform all the way around.
Correct.
Okay.
So of course you want to leave enough overhang for the hook tool. Get that. And so once again, as we present the hook tool, you want to present it, here's the hooks coming up here, you want to present it with the bottom of the hook at 12 o'clock, and then you'll turn it maybe to about 12:31 o'clock. If you have this hook piece, which is like the elbow, if you have that completely horizontal at 90 degrees, that's not good and your tool is likely to snap. So you want to keep it roughly at that 12 o'clock and you'll, as you're cutting, you'll open it just a little bit, not a whole lot. And so the first couple cuts, they're simple, I don't know. So what I'm doing is, so I'm going in and I'm gonna bring the outside diameter almost to the finish, and then I'll work my way back. And the hook tool is purely pull cuts. You don't ever want to push it. So right now my left hand is kind of serving as the pivot, and so more than my right hand, it's the left hand that's kind of pulling the tool out. And then after a while we'll put the pin in there. As you're going, you want to, of course, engage the tool at 12 o'clock and take your time engaging it. Then after it's cutting, then that's when you can roll it out just a little bit and pull it back. So I'm going to take out a little bit more and then we'll go back to the drill bit. So now I saved maybe the bottom 3/4, 3/8 inch. And now I'm gonna come back, finish drilling it out to the bottom. And then we'll kind of get to work on thinning this out. So now you can see where we are here. I think I measured it going to just about the end of the chuck here. Right now we're basically to the end of it, so we'll call that a good day. So while I still have some mass in the bottom, I'm going to kind of start to thin out this portion here. And hopefully the sidewalls do not go flying. If they do, Tom, they're going to hit you. What's my thickness? Right now, it's about an inch.
How thin do you think you can get it down to?
Easily an eighth.
That'll be enough to get light through it?
Yes, generally. With this being maple, especially the lighter wood, the light comes through quite a bit easier. And you also get different intensities of light, so we'll see that in a little bit. And so right now we start to use one of these lights to shine through to see how thick we are. It's nice when you have an LED light, but sometimes those go bye-bye.
Why don't you turn that overhead for us?
Yeah, there you go.
This one?
Yeah.
Yeah, turn it off.
Right behind you. Turn the switch. There you go.
Can you see anything?
Can you see it?
Yeah, you can see it.
So you can see a little bit here. And of course you have to be aware that the lighter wood will show more than like the darker wood. So know what kind of wood you're dealing with. But that's kind of what we see. And when you get there's kind of different intensities. When it's kind of that reddish orange, you know that you're relatively thick. And this is when you would caliper your walls so you know what thickness gives you that reddish hue. And then after you get it to be more like a whitish yellow, that means that you're really thinning it out, at least for maple. And after you know after you know what color you're looking for, you don't need the calipers anymore. It's nice when this light is not in your eyes as you turn. So right now you see no light in there, and we're gonna turn until you see light. Hopefully not past that. Another thing is that the shavings that come off will sometimes block your light, so recognize if you have shavings in there or not. So we still don't see any light through it, so we go a little bit more. And this is probably about when I want to stick my pin in there to help me out. When you feel that you're just working too much to pull that tool back. So now we can start to see something. And so, once again, where the wood is dark is sometimes a little harder to see. If you look up here, you have that more red hue. And then towards the end, it kind of gets a little more yellow. So where it's red, you know you can go a little bit more.
There's your lamp base.
I'm sorry?
There's a lamp base.
Yes. Oh, where? I don't know. I don't use lamps. And so on the inside you can see a little bit, and that's your guide. And as I look in there, you can see that red hue kind of right there. We know we can go a little bit more. The worst part about all these shavings that come off is that they get in your way. And so, sometimes the air will do it, sometimes the air won't do it because the centrifugal force is pushing them out. A lot of it, especially once you get down there, is about letting the tool cut. So you just give it its time so that it can cut. Once again, as you go in, always present the tool at that 12 o'clock so that you don't get it cast too early on.
Thank you.
coming along. As the shavings come out, on every, if the wood is punky, then you don't get a clean cut. But if you have good wood, then the cut's very clean, generally. So we might barely be seeing, we're about 1/4 inch, and you can just barely start to see some dark red in there. So we'll keep going. Again, just watch out for your shavings, because those will sometimes mislead you into thinking that you have more than you do. So this is kind of where we are right now. Can you see? There it is. Once again, on the edge is more yellowy, and as we get in, it gets a little darker. So we still have a little bit to take out there. if you heard not too long ago, it was kind of had a thunking sound. That's where it will sometimes not run round, run true. And if that happens more, then I go with the 6mm to even it back out. Let's see what we can see. You see that? So here we have, once again, it's still a little red, so it could go some more. Or maybe at a quarter inch. But we could hit it a little bit more. Let's finish it. You can also tune tool rest. We'll check that. So turn the tool rest to kind of get it in as much. Have a little wobble there. So now we're starting to see some stuff down here. Where that light is about down this way.
Yeah, what's that difference? Yeah, how thick are you, Titus?
I am not sure. Go ahead.
Is that flexing?
It flexes a little bit. No, this is not sure helps us. What's that, Bob? What's the measurement here?
16th of an inch for each change. So black is an eighth, red is a quarter.
So 5/16ths. That's down here. So I'm gonna switch to the 6mm because the hook tool does well as you're kind of pulling out, but once you kind of get to the bottom, sometimes the 6mm is a little bit better for you. kind of yellowish, and then right in the middle it gets a little too dark, and then it brightens back up just a little bit. So I'll touch up the, what is it called, the middle third of the bowl, and then that's about where I probably start sanding it after that.
Okay, what's the surface in respect to the hook tool and the carbide?
The surface?
Surface. Any better or any
less? Oh, hook tool versus the carbide? So in my hands, the carbide will sometimes give a little couple of ridges because it's around 6 millimeters versus the hook tool, which will tend to give a better cut and a better finish. Better finish. Like I said, you don't really see tear out unless it's some punky wood. Then you might see a little tear out here and there. And as you're making your passes, a couple things you see is each time you make a pass, it should get a little brighter in shade. And then you can also see shadows where your ridges are. And so if you have a nice ridge, that will show up as a dark shadow and you can go right back over that. It is. With once again, you can look at the different shades of red, the different shades of yellow, and that'll kind of let you know what your thinness is. And then from there, like Dave was saying, once it starts flexing too much, it's bound to flex out and then come in, you'll get a catch, and then you'll have kindling. But yeah, anyone have any questions?
Do you sand the inside?
You do sand the inside. Yes.
Wait till it dries? Hair dryer?
As long as it's not super wet, like as long as water is not pouring off of it, I would sand it. I don't necessarily wait for things to dry too much.
Hair dryer would.
Air dry can work as well.
Could dry it.
Right.
Or get it too hot.
Yeah.
Well, it's going to dry out the health of skin to some degree anyway. So if you go sand it, you better get busy and get it done.
Right.
Like right now. Right now would be a good time to go.
If you leave it for too long, it will start to split and crack on you because it is a lot thinner.
It's not like sangrate, it's ingrate.
Correct.
So you get a plus there.
You have this turned.
Yes.
You cut it off?
You can. Depends on what kind of lampshade you want. If you want to put the lamp in it, then you might leave it in.
And do not use an incandescent bulb?
Nothing. Nothing that would cause it to burn.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know if you could take the
bare flow, you can use whatever you want.
Take the metal part of an older shade and maybe attach it somehow or glue it in.
Right.
But definitely use LEDs.
Yeah, LEDs work well. They last long. And that's kind of it. And also, choice of wood. It's nice to get a lighter wood so that everything shows up pretty nicely for you. Besides that, because the darker wood, you'd have to turn it thinner to get that same light coming through. So that's kind of it.
Yeah. You say you cut it off at the top, or you take it off and drill a hole through for the top? Or?
Man, if I was gonna have a hole at the top, I would probably prefer to part it off, simply because cutting it with the amount of flex you might get.
Right.
To me, I'd prefer to have the hole as I part it off.
You just stick your hand in there to catch it?
If you want, or your neighbor's hand.
Do you oil it?
Yeah, I would oil it. I would oil it as right after sanding it. And I would do that so that to prevent it from cracking. Because it is green wood, it is wet. As I was turning it earlier today, just water was just coming out. And so if you let it dry, it'll crack. So then I do oil it.
Most people drill
the lights off before you even turn.
Offer. Oh.
You set your design up.
There you go. Offer on. That's it.
Turn it off again.
Any other questions?
When you're sanding it, you
have to look at the light. Come on, give it up. Let's hear it out there. Pretty boy.